Well, I think you have to begin with understanding what we've done to shut down. We haven't had a full shutdown, we've had a partial shutdown. And the shutdown has been around two important domains. It's been around gatherings and it's been around mobility. Gradually relaxing those restrictions, it will be interesting to see what the trade-off is between the rate of new infections and the relaxation of restrictions as we move forward. But I think that's the way in which we have to move. And both those will matter. And they will matter not just domestically, but they will also matter internationally. Migration, for example. Australia relies very heavily on migration. And migration ties in closely with education. If you think of a lot of our exports, a significant amount of our exports, is around people-based exports, tourism, education, business services. And those exports require our borders to be open, and open in a reasonably efficacious way, not open in a way that requires 2 weeks quarantine every time you cross the border. And that's going to take some time before that can be done safely. So until that happens, there's going to be a gloss on the economy that we're missing.
Look, I think it's about people. I think it's about people having the sensibilities around physical distancing. I think it's about staying connected to people. I think it's also about making sure people are spending again and going out and, you know, taking those holidays. Recovering from, I think, what's been a period of just really being quite separate from the world in some ways. And so I think it's a great opportunity for people to be thinking about how do we get businesses back on track, how do we reopen those businesses that have been partially shut down or fully shut down, and supporting them to get back on their feet.